بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Understand Al-Quran the easy way, course number 5, page 19, pointer C, that is lesson 19C, Al-Baqarah verses 132-133. Remember, we are learning the first juz, which started with Hidayah. Even Fatiha has dua of Hidayah, and then the Baqarah starts with Hidayah, that it will be given to Muttaqeen, not to Kafirin, not to Munafiqeen, and then the da'wah of the Quran is given, and the Adam alayhi salam is mentioned, and Prophet Adam alayhi salam is mentioned, who was the first person who was given Hidayah. After that, we have the second quarter and third quarter talking about Bani Israel, who did not value Hidayah. In fact, it goes on to page 16 and 17 also, and then from 18th page, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about Ibrahim alayhi salam. We are on the 19th page, where the pointers are construction of Kaaba and du'as, who will turn away from the religion of Ibrahim, instruction of Ibrahim alayhi salam and Yaqub, and that nation passed away. Or in short, as references or keywords, construction, religion, instruction, and nation. Construction, religion, instruction, and nation. Alim. Let's take third pointer now, instruction of Ibrahim and Yaqub alayhim as-salam. Earlier, Allah talked about Ibrahim's alayhi salam, Ibrahim's life, in previous verses. Now he talks about his concern at the time of his death. The lessons are Ibrahim and Yaqub alayhim as-salam advise their children to follow Islam. Their main concern at the time of their death was that their children stick to Tawheed, not to die as Muslims, that is, be a Muslim in every moment and situation. The new words are 101000, too few. Let's take the first verse. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. وَوَصَّى بِهَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ بَنِيهِ وَيَعْقُوبُ يَا بَنِيَّ إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَى لَكُمُ الدِّينَ فَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. And enjoined Ibrahim upon his sons and Yaqub, that is, Ibrahim and Yaqub enjoined, instructed his sons, Ibrahim instructed his sons, and Yaqub also did that. O my sons, indeed Allah has chosen for you the religion, so you should not die except while you are Muslims. You are submissive to Allah. Wawassa, and enjoined, instructed, biha it, Ibrahimu, Ibrahim alayhi salam, banihi, upon his sons. He enjoined upon his sons. And instructed who? His sons. Wa Yaqubu, and Yaqub also. Bu means subject. Yaqub enjoined his sons. Ibrahim and Yaqub enjoined their sons. Ya baniya, O my sons, inna Allah, indeed Allah, istafa, has chosen, lakum, for you, ad-deen, the religion. Indeed Allah has chosen for you the religion. The religion here, meaning the Islam. Fala tamutunna, so you should not die, illa, except wa antum, while you Muslimun, while you are Muslims, while you are submitting to Allah. Never die except while you are Muslims. No one knows when and where we will die. It means we should be Muslims in every moment and situation, so that when we die as Muslims. We should keep death and what is beyond it always in our mind. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, people will be resurrected in the same state in which they died. In the verses that we studied, there is ultimate parenting lesson to prepare our children to be obedient servants of Allah even after we die. They will take this legacy forward after we die. A man thinks, what will happen to my children after I die? He should be more worried and say, what will happen to my children when they die? Let us practice. Translate, wa wassa, and enjoined biha it Ibrahimu.
Ibrahim
alayhi salam. Banihi upon his sons. Banihi upon his sons. Wa Yaqubu and Yaqub. And enjoined Ibrahim upon his sons and Yaqub. Ali. Ya Baniya, O my sons, Inna Allah,
indeed Allah,
Ustafa, has chosen lakum for you ad-deena, the religion. Fala tamutunna, so you should not die, illa,
except
wa antum,
while you,
Muslimun,
are submissive.
O my son, indeed Allah has chosen for you the deen, so you should not die, except while you are Muslims, while you are submissive. Allim. Alhamdulillah. Let us take the next verse. Am kuntum shuhadaa idh hadara Ya'qub al-mawtu idh qala libanihi ma ta'buduna min ba'di. قالوا نعبد إلهك وإله آبائك إبراهيم وإسماعيل وإسحاق إلها واحدا ونحن له مسلمون. Or were you witnesses when came to Yaqub the death? That is when death came to Yaqub. When he said to his sons, "What will you worship after me?" They said, "We will worship your God and the God of your forefathers, Ibrahim and Ismail and Ishaq, one God, and we are submissive to him." Am, or, is a question word. Aw means or, am is or, but am is used in the sense of a question word. Am, or were you witness? Kuntum, were you shuhada, witnesses? Idh hadara, when came to Yaquba, Yaqub. Who came? Al-Mawtu, the deaths. Idh hadara Yaquba al-Mawtu. When death came to Yaqub. Idh qala, when he said, Libanihi, to his sons, Ma ta'buduna, what will you worship? Min ba'di, after me. Ma ta'buduna min ba'di. Qalu, they said, Na'budu, we will worship ilahaka, your God, wa ilaha abaika, and the God of your forefathers, Ibrahima wa Ismaila wa Ishaqa, ilahum wahida, one God. Wa nahnu, and we, lahu, to him, muslimun, submissive, submitting, and we are Muslims to him, we are submissive to him. Imagine for a moment, Yaqub alayhi salam dying, and his sons around him. They have seen his whole life dedicated to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Being a father and a prophet, how lovingly and caringly he must have taught them to be an obedient servant of Allah. Out of all that you have in this world, iman is the most precious for this life and the hereafter. The stakes in the hereafter are so high that Yaqub alayhi salam's last worry before leaving this world is about the faith of his children. In the verses that we studied, there is ultimate parenting lesson to prepare our children to be obedient servants of Allah even after we die, so that they take forward this legacy of worship. Why is Yaqub alayhi salam mentioned after Ibrahim alayhi salam? Because Bani Israel were his children. Israel means Yaqub. Israel is another name for Yaqub alayhi salam. This is the most important advice that was given by Ibrahim alayhi salam and Yaqub alayhi salam to their sons. Because they were prophets, it was their wasiyah, that is their will and advice. They said it at the time of dying. It was given to their children, and everyone wants to give the best to their children. And how happy and gratifying must be for him, Yaqub alayhi salam, to hear the positive reply from his sons, and same thing for Ibrahim alayhi salam. In the chain, Ismail alayhi salam is specially mentioned, who was among the forefathers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he was the uncle of Yaqub alayhi salam, because father of Yaqub alayhi salam is Ishaq alayhi salam, and brother of Ishaq alayhi salam is Ismail alayhi salam. Now we are talking of children of Yaqub talking to their father Yaqub alayhi salam and mentioning uncle's name. Because children of Yaqub alayhi salam did not have any discrimination. For them, children of Ismail alayhi salam were as honorable as the children of Ishaq alayhi salam. So please note that Bani Israel's chain is through Ishaq alayhi salam, Ishaq, Yaqub, and then onwards. It is a serious reminder for the mushriks of Makkah also, who used to take pride in Ibrahim alayhi salam as their father. Allah reminds here that the main concern of Ibrahim alayhi salam, even at the time of his death, was that his children worship Allah alone. No shirk. وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُسْلِمُونَ is the last part, that is, they submitted to Allah and not to their culture, customs, desires, or whims of anyone. The message is, are you truly following your forefather? Let's take a hadith. Anas radiallahu anhu narrated that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, when Allah wants good for a slave, he puts him in action. It was said, when Sahaba asked, how does he put him in action, O Messenger of Allah? He said, by making him meet up with the righteous deeds before death. That is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives him tawfiq to do good deeds before his death, and he meets Allah in the best condition. Can you translate? Am or kuntum, were you shuhada, witnesses, idh hadara Yaqub,
when came to Yaqub
al-mautu, the death. Or were you witnesses when death came to Yaqub alayhi salam? Allim. Idh qala li banihi, when he said to his sons, ma ta'buduna, what will you worship, min ba'di, after me. When he said to his sons, what will you worship after me? Allim. Qalu,
they said,
na'budu,
we will worship
ilahaka,
your God.
Wa ilaha,
and the God,
aba'ika, Ibrahima, wa Ismaila, wa Ishaqa,
of your forefathers, Ibrahim and Ismail and Ishaq.
Ilaham wahida,
one God.
So they said, we will worship your God and the God of our forefathers, Ibrahim and Ismail and Ishaq, one God. Allim. وَنَحْنُ
and we,
لَهُ مُسْلِمُونَ
are submissive to him.
And we are submissive to him. We are Muslims. Allim. Alhamdulillah. Let's take lessons now. Ibrahim alayhi salam and Yaqub alayhi salam advised their children to follow Islam. Their main concern at the time of their death was that their children stick to Tawheed. Not to die as Muslims, that is, be a Muslim in every moment and situation, because we don't know when the death will come. A dua can be, O Allah, make us and our children true Muslims. A plan can be, inshallah, I shall teach and give tarbiyah to my children to live according to Islam, so that they live according to Islam. Let's take the last part now. Asma and Af'al. Important Asma. Ya Baniya. Well, how is it formed? Ibn, plural of Ibn, is Abna or Banun or Baneen. Baneen means sons. Now be careful. Ibn, plural is Baneen. And also Abna and Banun. If you add Baneen to Israel, the noon is dropped. Bani Israel. The children of Israel. Similarly, Baneen and E, my sons. If you want to say my sons, sons of mine, or Baneen, E, my sons, will be Baniya, because noon is again dropped. So you will have Ya and Ya. So Baniya. Baniya means my sons. Ya Baniya, O my sons. Allim. Alright, Ad-Din, plural is Adyan, religions. And we have Aba, that is plural, singular is Ab. Plural is Aba. Can you give me the plural? Deen,
Adyan.
Ab, Aba. Let's take three letter sound verbs now. Hadara, came. Repeat after me. Hadara, yahduru, uhdur.
Hadara, yahduru, uhdur.
Hadir, mahdur, hudur.
Hadir, mahdur, hudur.
Allim. Na'budu. Na'budu, we worship. So he worshipped Abada. You know this. Abada Ya'budu. U'bud, Abid, Ma'bud, Ibadah. Alim. Alright, let us take three-letter weak verb. Kuntum. Show the sign. Kuntum. You were. So he was Kana. That's also very simple. But repeat after me. Kana Yakunu Kun.
Kana Yakunu Kun.
Kain dash Kaun.
Kain dash Kaun.
Alim. Mouth. Show the sign, mouth. Mouth, death. So what is he died? Mata. Repeat after me. Mata yamutu mut.
Mata yamutu mut.
Mayit dash mouth.
Mayit dash mouth.
Alim. So there are some special forms because of weak letters. This is not ma'it, it is mayit. Let's take mazid fi verbs now. Wassa, enjoined, instructed. Okay. So repeat after me. Wassa, yuwassi, wassi.
Wassa, yuwassi, wassi.
Muwassin, muwassa, tawsiya.
Muwassi, muwassa, tawsiya.
Ali. Istafa, we saw this verb before. He chose. Istafa, he chose. Repeat after me. Istafa, yastafi, istafi.
Istafa, yastafi, istafi.
Mustafin, mustafa, istifa.
Mustafin, Mustafa, Istifa,
Alim. We have Muslimun, but you know that Aslama, Islima, Aslim, Muslim, Muslim, Islam. Alhamdulillah, don't forget the seven types of homework and don't forget the dua, Rabbi Zidni Ilma, and the dua for your classmates. And learn from videos, together is best. And try to be a teacher and get the training if you need. May Allah help us to recite, understand, ponder, implement, propagate, and memorize the Quran. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu alaykum. Learn to read Al-Quran, learn Tajweed, understand Al-Quran and memorize it using easy, scientific, and interactive methods. Get ebooks, videos, audios, posters, PowerPoint files, app links for different courses. We have specialized Montessori materials and games for making the Quran easy for kids and a teacher's resource center too. Get personalized one-to-one online courses that suit your needs from expert teachers. For free trial, write to admin@understandquran.com or visit understandquran.com. Wassalamu alaikum.